sorry jare sorry mi mo ko to se phone mi I don't know what is wrong with my phone mi mo kini e se ko show ni okay mi and se mo ejo okay some people awon eyan kan te send the kini si mi. Some people don't understand Yoruba. It's just that, you know, when you are so tired, you will just resort to your mother tongue. That's just it. Please, I beg you, do not spread news of what you don't know. Number one fact, from day one, she explained what had happened. Please. She said us, oh, this person, this is what he did to me. He defiled her. She said it. And the painful part is, she was questioned. She was asked to write statements. From morning, she wrote statements. Afternoon, she was questioned. Till night, almost 8:30, a young child. She went through a lot. Okay, Iyabo. Iyabo Tidebi, Iyabo Oya request to Iyabo request. Please, I beg you, please. The stress was too much for me, for her. Questioning a child from morning to night. You understand what I'm saying? It was too much. I felt so bad. Iyabo Bawoni. Iyabo, this is the first time I'm seeing you come since this started. Iyabo, all of my jokes are me. My neighbors came here. They said, have I seen your videos? I said that we were together. I want to play our old videos here. King Lord, go. Please, I want in your knee. Originally, she long saw. One knee among you. So, when one rape, one what is so? Larity, I said. A lady to a shame. A lady, to support sexual assault. I'm vlogger. I need for work hotel, work kitchen. Money, aha. He leaked out.
Yeah, because you see, a lot of people lack integrity.
Yeah, but my
a lot of people lack. And you know, there's a lot of mental people walking and roaming the streets. And a lot of people does not have the capacity to understand. And we have a lot of illiterates also. And this thing called rape is like a norm in Nigeria. It's like a normal thing. Like, there's no big deal because they are used to it. You understand? So that's exactly the issue we have. A lot of people don't even find nothing wrong in what he did. A lot of people see it as a very small crime. And, you know, like, the reason why a lot of young girls don't come out to talk is because of situations like this. Because no matter how they say it, no matter how they cry it out, they will still be questioned. They will still be questioned.
They question
her. They will ask them, are you sure? How can a child tell you that I am raped? And you're asking the child, are you sure?
They question
her. Then you ask the child. You will ask the child, did he touch you or he put it inside? At he touch you, at he put inside, the okiwani yato. They have normalized it. And that is why a lot of people, I have blocked over 50 people because of this issue on my page. Because I don't really have that energy to be exchanging words with people. You understand? Like I said, even if there was no evidence, the fact that that girl can open her mouth and say, after 7 years, you know, she was 7 years old. That, you see, that trauma, it never goes away. Sometimes it will disappear because I remembered my own. You know, I told you, I didn't really do a video about the molestation. You understand? Because it was done by a family member. And I don't, it will be disastrous. So, you understand what I'm saying?
I know.
You understand what I'm saying? But you know what? You see, the few years I left the house, to go and stay with my mom, I forgot about it.
Yeah.
The day I came back to that house, That was the day I relived everything again. And it was like a nightmare. It was like a dream. It was like a trance. So people who have not been there sometimes may not understand how damaging molestation and rape is.
See, how does a seven-year-old that you raped, not that you kissed her. You can't even, how do you kiss, how does a grown man, a 41-year-old?
Even if you kiss her, that is a violation, that is wrong already.
He's a minor. I don't even understand why some bloggers or some people are trying to, you know, paint it. Seven, and she described him completely. She described everything, every single detail. Do you understand? Now, this recent one was so bad for me because I know the way some people behave sometimes. Like, they will be telling you, oh, it's not true, it's not true. For us to be watching it even on CCTV was painful for me, for that girl to even relieve that moment. Now, he going...
You didn't see when my friends were watching it today. You didn't see the way they were so tense. You didn't see the way they were shaking. They couldn't even watch it.
Now, they elite are...
There is no normal person that will watch that video and act normal.
30 minutes. 30 minutes. How many adults can even stomach that? And was doing all sorts that I can't even say.
Now, a lot of people did not understand why I came for Yomi like that. When I did the first video, I told you now that when I did the first video asking them to pipe low, when he sent that insulting chat to me, immediately I called him, he didn't pick. I started to send him voice notes. We chatted for almost going to 1.5 hours. And I was explaining to him, I was telling him, I have watched this video, Yomi. He said, ah, Moni, go and watch it. Oh, yeah, Ojo Moni Ribio. At the end of the day, he said, we cannot fight, but I should have called him behind closed doors. Okay. And I told him that if that is what is upsetting you, Mabino. I did not know where Otilabu Misori page in social media. I thought it was what you had. So that is like, even after I have told you, Mosi Ri video, you are asking us to post it. You are telling me, now, what I want to ask Nigerians is that, Princess Mabino, what I want to ask Nigerians is that, the confession that we post alone, look at the reaction, though. It's only confession that we have posted, though. So if we now release that video footage, the original Coco, the main crime itself, how do you think people will sleep tonight? How do you think people will accept it? And how do you think they will react?
How can you be asking for the... When can Yomi produce the video he's had with his wife? It's like you, even Agbalagba. Please, let's think about this thing. You are even me, a grown woman. If you tell me to produce a video of me making out with a man, it's somehow... That one is even consensual. Please, you are saying sexual assault. It doesn't mean anything. It's when you assault somebody, perform sexual act on a minor, not a lady, not a woman. So I don't know where Yomi comes off. Me or Kilarigbo nkan to nso yi. But everybody have been telling me, Mommy P, go to Iyabo Ojo's page. So but I say lonely or so I will go to your page. Up until now, me say, where I come back, one need to, if I go to Iyabo Ojo's page, if that's why I told you that. For me, what is most painful is that people are even looking for validation for something that is bad. It doesn't matter if his business is adopted child, or Yabo's just housemate, or Mr. Peter's niece. What matters is children are meant to be protected. Children are not playthings that you fiddle with. Children are not things or humans or ladies that you perform sexual acts on. I hope your mom is watching this. Kororie ko suka ko suorun meta ti eyan sun to ba ni ironu Yomi Fabiyi ko ro ni ala mo so pelu ase Olorun gbogbo awon to ti ara e jade Yomi won ma experience kini in tenfold to ba experience I will come out ma ja fun won but inu mi adun wa so fun mi igba yen ni pe princess this is how I feel for everybody who is saying, oh, it's not a minor issue. It's just a minor. Nothing is minor. If it is in another country, self, they will put him in confinement, prison, solitary. If he was abroad, that they arrested somebody and molested a child, it's the prisoners that we even start dealing with him. How can we in Nigeria normalize an adult performing serious sexual acts on a child for 30 minutes? How can somebody like Yomi ask for evidence? How can Foluke Damola, who is a rape survivor, even think me or Lake?
The last one for me, because Yomi, when we had that issue, he later sent me a message and said, we should not fight, blah, 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 blah. You understand? No, and thank God for some, and thank, she yeah, saw, and thank God for some reason.
She said for some sorry reason. For She did not know it was my, she was, the person was even related to me or my adopted daughter. But you know what, you know what my own is. Whether the child was abandoned in the gutter, whether the child
does it matter?
A banana seller, whether the child is Tontodike's child, the child is a child. We have the responsibility of securing those children. Nobody has the right.
Do you know why I love it?
Nobody has the right. The video of an adult, a 48-year-old man. Can it be? He just got it be money. He doesn't have kids yet. Kalote be money. Kalote te be more. That's his grandchild. Kini koti and so out. Ah. Odu mi. Odun eledam
the last straw for me with Yomi, because when to say she ba mi so pe so she bi mi ti mi ni aleja lanu, I was like, I don't want to answer him that yesterday pe ti ba ji laaro yi ma se wa pe, I will call him and then I will really give him my heart to heart. Omo, and I woke up this morning and found out that he granted an interview with she Goldmine, that people stating that
it's like I'm on
that Baba Ijesha, that he went to see Baba Ijesha, and Baba Ijesha said he didn't confess to the crime. Ah, Omo, oh, that bad that Timo Fueni, Omo, release the video.
That interview on your page. Wait, the insults that insulted me, is it on your own page? Because everybody has told me if I want any updates on this issue, I should go to your page. Is that interview on your page?
I posted it on my page. I posted it. It's there.
Because me, le lost Instagram. Nitori shemokwe awa elomi or oton sogon wanti fe yi or tami lori. But ma lo si page ma lo.
Take it easy.
Yomi Fabi, it be keep it over one year late. Bobby Moyen Sofwen, Bob, a fitic of a seal long, most ceremonial to one lash. Ah! Along, I called you see it. I see ya, got to say ya fije. Oh, my wife, I want to explain to you, Yomi. I want to, Yabba, I'm coming. I want to explain to you. Children are the heritage of God.
Of course.
God loves children. God loves children. And he specifically said, let them come up to me. He loves them. You know me? You now decided that you wanted to shame a God's child. Abi, you wanted to shame. You wanted offense shame on alone. Offense shame gift alone. You know me? Warija alone. Mm-hmm.
He said that they might sue us for defamation of character. I'll be sued. I'm looking at talking rubbish now. He was speaking in the rubbish and in the stupidity. You don't understand. He was speaking in the rubbish and in the stupidity. You cannot come and be sending me message at my behind closed doors, and then you come out and be doing gala. Is that like you are a repentant soldier? Or you understand, or you are not a repentant soldier. Stand with one. Don't do a gabagibi.
You know what I'm thinking now? Can you hear me, Yabo? That means if it was even somebody like me that was assaulted, people would say, Egbojumbe, Shebi, you are not a child. That means that's what people will say. If you people can see reason, can validate a 48-year-old man performing sexual act on a 14-year-old for 30 minutes. This country is gone.
There's some people are saying, how can a child be molested for 7 years? And then
she wasn't molested.
The mother does not know.
She wasn't molested for
7 years. Let me tell you something, people. See, Nigerians, we have a problem. We have a problem of not wanting to accept. We're in denial, and we need to understand the fact. Fathers, they rape their own children. Stepfathers, they rape their own children. Uncles, they rape their own children. Cousins, they rape their own uncles rape their own nieces and nephews. Cousins, they do the same. Houseboy, they do the same. See, people that are close to you are those that are those government shenanigans? Are those that molest your children and you have to be careful? And let me tell you, they don't just do it and tell them it's okay to talk to it, to talk to your mom and dad about it. They do it and they threaten them. They do it and they threaten them. So, you people, if you don't know what's up, you better begin to know what's up now. Even Obiri, women, the women rape young boys. Women, they rape young boys. All these aunties, I've heard a lot of my friends gist me about how all these their aunties disbarging them. Some of them even told me that it's their house that disbarging them. So this thing, people should stop trying to normalize it. It is not normal.
Justice, please. Please, it's not easy for me, I beg. But come manage, I mean.
You don't even have that is married, that has had sex and everything together, right? If she comes, wakes up one night, or she wakes up one morning, or just decide one day to say, don't touch me, I'm not interested, and you force her against her wish, it is rape.
Anyway, I've said my piece.
A seven years old girl.
Seven. And you are saying. And so people are even saying, well, why did she talk? Are you all right? Have you seen a 41-year-old man threatening a 7-year-old not to talk? I have said, some of you that have even been maybe cheated, not even raped, that have even been duped. You'll be saying, I'm even ashamed to say, they took me. Not stuck up. A 7-year-old girl that was threatening.
Princess, let me even shock you. You see, at that age, Seth doesn't even know what happened. She doesn't even know. She doesn't even understand. Yes, she might not even know how to describe it.
And when they asked him in a separate room, he explained in detail, right, Gami? He explained in detail, only for him to be telling me yesterday. When they said he slept, I said, who is there? Wallo Sofumi. You said, that time I was impotent. Please, if you are impotent, it doesn't mean you can't have sex. It just means your sperm cannot bring children. It's like my ear wanted to fall off yesterday. How can you say that?
You can't take meds. Calm yourself down. We need all the energy. You know me, I've told you.
People, you know.
Energy. On this case, I'm not backing down.
Oh, sure.
I'm not backing down.